Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the introduction of FET, which is field effect transistor, differences between BJT and FET, and the construction of N-channel and P-channel FED. Today, we will discuss about the working of N-channel FET. Let us consider the structure of N-channel FET. Let us apply voltage between the drain terminal and source terminal, and also let us apply the voltage between the gate terminal and source terminal. The voltage between drain and source, we will call that as VDS, and the voltage between gate and source, we will call that as VGS. For an N-channel FET, VDS should be always positive voltage, and VGS is taken in two cases. First case, VGS will be made 0, and in the second case, VGS is taken as negative voltage. Let us consider the first case, where VGS is equal to 0 and VDS is made some positive voltage. So, let us make VGS as 0. So, let us connect a wire from gate and connect it to source, short this, then connect a ground to source. This will make VGS, voltage between gate and source, as 0, and we need to connect some positive voltage between drain and source. Let us take a connection, let us make a connection, positive, negative, and connect it to source. So, this voltage is VDS, which will be positive and negative. Here, drain is connected to positive terminal, hence the electrons which are present in N channel will move towards drain. It will move towards drain. This will constitute the source current as well as the drain current. As we can observe, the N type is connected to positive and the P side is connected to ground. So, as we can see, N-type material is connected to positive terminal and P-type is connected to negative terminal. This is sufficient for reverse bias condition. Reverse bias condition, and we know in reverse bias condition, the depletion region will increase. The depletion region will increase. As VDS is increased, the current ID will also increase, and the depletion region towards the drain will also increase. Like this, the depletion region will increase. And at some point, both the depletion region looks as if they are touching with each other. This condition we will call that as pinch off condition, and the voltage for which we obtain pinch off is known as pinch off voltage, VP. Once the applied voltage reaches VP, the current will become constant. The current which is flowing through the device will become constant. Now, let us plot a graph of VDS versus ID. So, VDS is taken in X axis, ID is taken in Y axis. So, as we keep on increasing VDS from 0 to higher positive value, current will increase linearly. Once this applied voltage reaches pinch off voltage, the current become constant. Current will become constant due to narrow depletion region. The region where the current increases linearly, we'll call that region as ohmic region, and the region where the current is constant, we'll call that as saturation region. So the point from where the current become constant is known as pinch off voltage, and this maximum current is known as IDSS. This is the maximum current, this is the maximum current for VGS is equal to 0 and VDS is equal to VP. Now let us consider the second case where VGS is made less than 0 and VDS is taken as some positive voltage. If we take VGS as less than 0, which means we need to connect negative terminal to gate and positive terminal to source. So you can see here, so we have made the connection, negative terminal is connected to gate and positive terminal is connected to source. The effect of connecting negative voltage to the gate is that we will obtain VP at the lower levels of VDS, which means the current will become constant for lower level of VDS and also current will decrease. Let us say we have connected VGS as minus 1. The first graph is obtained for VGS is equal to 0. Now let us consider VGS as minus 1. For VGS is equal to minus 1, we will obtain VP, which is new VP for lower level of VDS, which means the current will decrease here, current will decrease, as well as the current will become constant for the lower level of VDS. The relation between VGS and ID can be written as ID is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP whole square. Now this term ID will be constant, this term is constant. IDSS and VP are both constant and we are varying VGS. If VGS is made equal to VP, if we make VGS is equal to VP, at that case ID will become 0 from the above equation. In the same way here, if we make, as we keep on decreasing the voltage, so as we make VGS equal to VP, we will get ID is equal to 0, and the region where the FET is not conducting, we will call that region as the cutoff region. And the characteristics which we have obtained here, we will call that as drain characteristics. The characteristics is drain characteristics. As VDS is increased above the permissible level, the device will break down and high current will flow through the device. The region where the junction breakdown occurs is known as the breakdown region. Breakdown region. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.